Christmas Corner with Ken, who is making decorative DIY feather Christmas trees that are great for any holiday display. We're really excited about that. But before we do that, we're even more excited about what I'm about to tell you. We'd like to remind everyone that Hallmark Channel's Holiday Home Decoration Sweepstakes is still well underway. Hallmark Channel is giving one lucky viewer, that could be you, the chance to have this guy right here, the one and only Ken Wingard.
The man, the myth, the legend.
All of those things turn their home into the envy of everyone in their neighborhood, and it is super easy to enter.
It is. It is very easy. All you have to do is go to hallmarkchannel.com/Christmas, fill out the entry form there. Now, to earn extra submissions, you can digitally decorate up to 10 rooms per day.
And it's really fun.
So much great stuff, trees, stockings, so much more. And then be sure to share your favorite room on Twitter. That counts as one more additional entry. 12 in total every single day. The deadline to get your submissions in is September 21st. Good luck, everybody.
I'm so excited about this whole thing.
You should be.
I am delighted.
I mean, do you need any help? We'd like to come too.
My assistant.
I will be your assistant. I'll just be like, you're in.
So exactly. We'll show you how to make these beautiful feather Christmas trees. So how do we make these, Ken? They're so unique.
Yeah, I think they're very unique. I think they're great for holidays. They're great at other times. I've been seeing them around in some high-end stores, so I decided let's tackle making them. All you're going to need are feathers, and I'll talk a little bit more about those later, and a styrofoam cone from any craft store. It's very, very easy. So easy.
Oh, no.
So I'm going to show you how to do this.
Yeah.
So you take your styrofoam, your feathers, get feather trim that's already going to come sort of together like this. That's what makes it super easy. And what you're going to do, Cameron, a little bit of hot glue here.
You got it.
Careful.
In a line, though, yeah?
Yeah. There you
all
go.
Around.
Just a little dot. That's all you need. That's all you need. Because you know, and then you're just going to overlap the bottom a little bit, and then you're just going to start, Debbie, I'm going to put you to one, two here. And then just start to twirl it up.
If you see where is he going to glue again?
You just glue like every, you don't have to glue every round, just a little dot.
Can you see that? Just do a little glue, and then you wrap that.
And then you can wrap it around another few times, and then put another dot.
And as we're doing this, let me ask you, like this is, you know, these feathers are about 2 to 3, maybe 4 inches in total. Can you get feathers different sizes depending on the size of your cone?
Well, when I started doing research, I was shocked. Online craft stores, fabric stores, the number of different types of feathers you can get.
Yep.
These smaller ones in white, you can get these sort of longer 6-8 inch ones here.
Yep.
You can get brown ones. You can also get ones that are dyed different colors. One thing you want to make sure, I'm going to show you here on this one, feathers have a certain curl to them. See how these are curling out versus in? So you want to do them so that they're curling out. And that's really going to give you, if you notice here, the way you all are working on it.
Gives it more dimension, doesn't it?
Exactly.
Yeah, now, it kind of jumps out.
Can I ask you also about the glue? Because I know that styrofoam and the hot glue, it could burn the styrofoam, no?
It is. Luckily, we're not going to see it, so you can get away with it. If you have a low temperature setting on your glue gun, this is the time to use it.
Yeah, okay. Right.
But because everything it is melting the styrofoam a little bit, you're not going to see it. So you will very, very good job. I'm just going to cut
Yeah, cut a little piece there so we can finish up the
I'm trying to impress you so I can be your assistant when you go to everyone's home to decorate.
Debbie, Cameron, and Ken will come to your house.
That's right.
There you go.
Yeah, so it's that easy to do it. The feathers are very inexpensive.
That's
fine. Styrofoam is. Now, to finish the top, Debbie, if you want to just give me a whole bunch of glue right here on this top piece of ribbon.
On the ribbon?
On the ribbon.
Okay.
And all you do is
take... All the way around?
There you go. That's good.
Okay.
All you're going to do is take some feathers that you have cut off from your trim, and you're just going to pop it right there up top. And that's going to sort of cover up
anything right there. Now, what about those peacock feathers that you have there? Because they're longer than what we just used.
So I want to show you. So you know how I talked about that curve on the feather? So I did this one here with these black feathers.
Those are
black
gorgeous.
And green.
Gorgeous.
But the green is only on one side. And to get that, so I have to have the curve going in the other way.
Okay.
It's sort of missing something. So I added the peacock feathers, which are quite common around here. And all you're going to do is clip those.
So you're going to cut that entire stem off because they come like this.
They come super, super long.
They
and then you're just going to find a little spot, and once you're done with your tree, just tuck that under. And you can do this with anything. You can do it with feathers. You can do it with little ornaments.
What a cute idea.
It really looks
so
good.
The magic happen.
Now, what about, like, can you add a tree topper, some sort of a topper to this?
I'm so glad you asked.
Well, I saw it sitting there, and I was like, I wasn't sure where that's going to go. There we go.
All I did, a little ornament here, and what I did on the back, I got a bamboo skewer, put it through the back, and then will you do the honor?
Okay.
Straight into the top because it's really easy to get through that trim.
Okay.
Straight in, down.
There it is.
Oh,
as easy as that.
And this is so fun and so quick. We literally just did this in segment, no pre-tape.
And then when it comes to actually displaying the camera,
what would you do?
Pop this. I love sort of mixing them in with different decor. Like, I think the white ones look very good in a traditional perfect.
This is very helpful to show us how to display it. Sometimes you have these and you don't
exactly know. Just did
the little top. Where would you,
right there. I love like separating them out. The sort of green and gold, I think, works great with sort of gold foliage, sort of green and silver and gold ornaments. And my favorite.
That's beautiful.
Is there this that the speaking of the holiday home decorating, the room that you did with the
this would look great.
It's very Cameron. This one
I'm
dedicating
look good in your room, Deb.
The white ones went. I love that too. Ken, you are so wonderful.
We're gonna pack these up and bring them with us.
Yeah, we are. We are. Don't you worry. We're gonna be there with Ken, just so you know. You're getting
and
more bang for your buck. For full instructions, you visit HallmarkChannel.com.